have always encouraged anyone to start a podcast today. So if you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. So let me explain. And this is the app I'm actually using to make this podcast. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. And Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. And you can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place. So download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started.
Starting your journey to financial freedom.
Now.
You're listening to the New Investor Podcast.
It is amazing the number of things I have learned, the new skills I have acquired in the last 5 months, more on investing, broadcasting, publishing, and e-commerce. We all have it in us, and we all have it in us. I say it again, and it is all there screaming to get out from in the insides of you. So we all have a shot. I am in the process of setting up foundations towards financial freedom and eliminating any form of regret. There is always one more thing you can do or research that could support your projects. It would be a mistake to be thinking that we will get it right the first time and that we have nailed the whole story. The market is the one dictating your next moves. It is up to you to find ways to adapt and get the attention you believe you deserve. And I don't think that only 20 years ago I could have done some radio or published a book in 5 months. It is indeed probably the best time to be alive if you want to build something for yourself. I can only but recommend you to try this adventure before you are filled with regret or miss on the opportunity of becoming the person you believe right now you can never be. There is always time if you want to reach your objectives and your dreams and even plant some seeds. We're talking here building foundations. I'm not saying that it will be successful from the get, right? But you are planting seeds, so you are putting all the chances on your side for these projects to become successful. Time is the most valuable commodity, and we may have been already provided with much more of it. Hence, more time to build wealth. I also believe that the majority of your investments in your lifetime must be made as of today and not in 10 years or 20 years. That is the window we have before everyone else starts investing, before the robots and artificial intelligence algorithm take charge of Wall Street and the markets, because, you know, if that happens, the stock market will become safer and predictable, and many people will have confidence then in putting their money into play, and less opportunity for us early investors. Investing is easy. There can be a lot of money in it if you are able to add discipline and patience in your life, coupled with running a complete audit of your lifestyle. And I have another $20,000 to build to reach my objective this year. There is 5 months left. The math are serious to be able to achieve that. I seriously live like I am broke. Every single expense I recorded practically on daily basis to always update my financial status. Forget what people may say, as that seems to be the only major obstacle to one's success: other people's opinion. So to be clear, if you record your expenses and not spend your money on stupid things to impress, you are not stingy. You are just an investor being smart about money. If you ride the bus for 45 minutes every day to work two jobs, live with mom, own nothing, and not spend your mornings at expensive coffee shops, you are not stingy or a loser. You are an investor being smart about money. Being smart about money is your getaway to formidable success as an investor. And this does not mean being smart about corporate finance or trading securities. It is about understanding the value of money, understanding that $10 can become $1,000. I recently reposted on my Instagram that basically described the lifestyle you are to commit to and maintain, to have a glimpse of hope of building serious wealth at a young age. The post received a lot of engagement, a lot of comments, but one thing was very clear. It does seem that 1% of the people understand the level of sacrifice that such requires. If this is what you aspire to, if this is what you really want, well, allow me to lay it down for you, and there is no other way you can achieve this, none at all. Your teens, 20s, and early 30s will be about extreme sacrifice, not friends and parties. Save 50% of your salary every single month. Make calculated investments with 100% of these savings consistently and without fail in perpetuity. Take no debt, spend only what you have and what you have budgeted to spend. Live with the strict minimum throughout your early adult life. Spend an ungodly amount of time exploring your passions and making hundreds of attempts to build a business around them without raising any money from anyone, and that would mean extra jobs. Friends and family around you must be pouring unlimited amount of energy and positivity to you, and if that means only hanging out with two people for 20 years, so be it. If you have no passion for it, if every hour of your day are not aimed at supporting your objectives, you must understand from now that it will most probably fail, but you need to embrace failure, as you will fail at something at some point, and you will learn from it and you will do better. Finally, it will never be about money. There is more, believe me, but what a life to commit to. I truly believe that the most successful people on the planet have understood this at a very early stage. And I woke up in my late 30s myself. While I do not aim at changing the world, I aim at changing my world. And that's enough for me in this life. So it is never too late. I think it is about perspective. It seems everyone aspires to change the world until they realize they can't and they give up. Change your world. Thank you for listening to the podcast, and I really hope that it brings you some additional support on your own journey towards financial freedom. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to never miss an episode, and looking forward to your DM and follow on Instagram at New Investor Podcast. In the meantime, stay invested, be patient, and keep playing the long-term game.